My name is Edmond Moitisetagu. I work in mining technical services as a system administrator. So I'll be taking you through how our boom gate works in case in line with gas system. Our boom gate here is made to make sure that each and every vehicle that is going to the fit is fitted with the collision avoidance system. If the system is not working, the boom gate won't open for you. Then you have to go back and find our engineering department so that they can fix it for you, so that you can be able to access the pit from the boom gate. Very important for small vehicles, because as they go into the pit, they come across our haul trucks, our shovels, our graders, our dozers, so that when they're in the pit, they can communicate with each other. Safety has improved a bit in the pit. We have minimal collision avoidances that are happening around the pit. Even our operators and drivers, they are very keen to use the system as well.
Hi, my name is Tebe Sibina. I'm the maintenance engineer for utilities. My role basically covers the electrical and instrumentation workshops. In terms of the SafeMine system, we basically cover the maintenance of the system, the maintenance and the servicing of the equipment, and attending to breakdowns if and when they occur. The other area where we look at is in terms of the new system now, the importance of that system is to make sure that we don't have vehicles colliding or areas where we have two different types of equipment, making sure that the operators are aware that they have other vehicles in the area. In terms of the new changes now is every morning, in terms of the pre-start checklist, the vehicles now have to check and make sure that the system is operational. Where it's not operational, they engage a control room or dispatch and get our teams out, deploy our teams to go and attend to the problems to make sure that system is operational. In terms of the maintenance side of the SafeMine system, I think it's been a very good system. It's made our guys very much aware in terms of how they are in the areas where they're working, and in terms of other machines in the pit.
As an operator, that truck. Total truck I can introduce a little bit of work. This is my sixth year I can take operator. Can I lead the Moronia and a Tiana, or the Manuel and Tilco Morao up to the field? This is a safe mind. Now, one of the motors I am a set. What can I make of kids of Kuni? I am a set. It is before we are now. Walk on one of our truck. Yeah, one of our beginning to my mind. When over high notes, not a man, when you go away, remember, for instance, what you know, bless me, the India, how you believe what I want, just out of the good. So, we come on a line time, what she told me how to motor I got that get to never get to a hell of a hand. So, come on, hell of an hour, and go walk in the good thing. You
do have Tabo Mogoti, Matwa Kota 18. I'm Gabarga Mujan and mine as a driver operator. Says the ground, what can not five can go operate. Ka botlalo ya ka bokhutshwane tiro ya operation ke tiro e matsetselo ke tlhoka gore bo le dijwale tota because ha re bereka ka metšhini e tshwana le traka ya batla o le kelotlhoko because go na le di-blind spot o e le gore o bona mo blind spot o bona within 15 meters ha e le gore go na le motšhini o ka ga tlase ga a distance ya 15 meters mo blind spot ga kwa bao. So o tshwanela ke gore jaaka re bona gampieno go na ditopo tsa dicamera le tsa di-sound tse di thusang tota gore e re ga gona motšhini wa gautshwane di kgone go aleta well in time before o ka emelela o pele o ka thula. So ke improvement e tona mo go rona e leng gore e re bereketse thata mo le gore collision ke dumela e gokotsegile thata mo maotong a jwane mae. Motšhino wa taraka ke motšhino o rwala mmu go tswa kwa tlase mo piting go isa ko totomeng ko didampong. Motšhino wa safe mine ke motšhino ore tota ya lagone tiro yone ke go alert mo go ka thuleng metšhine kana sepe selo se le gautshwane le wena. Jaanong jaaka o ntse lana ke wa re bontsha jaaka go na le camera go na le sound. Sound ha approacha motšhini ya nna close to you o raise alarm e le gore ke yone e le gore tego bola gore watch out go na le motšhine kana sepe se se gautshwane le wena. Since re tse dua equipment ya safe mining go tlhwa ditsela thata ka gore ke le mogara ga se go motho o ka itlhala o go tlhanele motšhini o mongwe o sa o bone wa bo o se go bontshe ga leela wa leng time gore go na le motšhini wa gago change operation o bone o lebe mo ditlhakong tsa gago kana go botse lebelo sepela sa gore se ka go thusang tota gore o nne o lebe o bone tota ela nnang ka leboga tota ela gore o bo bogori or management wa rona o ntse o lemoga di botlhokwa ba dilo tse ka gore kampieno ana wa re berekela tota wa rentsha mo dikotsing dilo tse tsotlhe tse di ka re ba balelang o ise safety ko godimo thata mo go rona.
Hi, I'm Candy Godi. I'm a senior mining engineer responsible for loading and hauling at Cut 6 and 7. Look, it wasn't such a good era. Prior to the system, we've had a number of collision accidents, and if I could just specifically talk to safety, we are all aware that safety is something that we should not compromise at all, and we must make sure that at all times our employees are very safe. So prior to introduction of collision avoidance, like I said, we've had a number of collision incidents, whether between EMV or EMV and LDVs, but we've had a number of those. To align to zero harm, we had to make sure that we eliminate and reduce or where possible eliminate incidents. For us, to be able to have no collisions at all is a plus because it really promotes our safety performance and running. The utilization is quite good. It's currently installed in most of the equipment, frontline equipment, all the machines have got a safe mine, also the LDVs. So it's very important for us to be able to see, or from the system be able to see that we are having some moving machinery passing each other or interacting. So at this point, all frontline equipment, all LDVs entering the pit are installed with safe mine. A very good performance in the first half of the year. We've literally eliminated incidents in Cut 6 and 7. We've only had a couple, but I must admit that compared to the previous years, we've seen a drastic improvement in that space. Zero harm is very key in our operation, and we really are aiming to eliminate incidents as per the zero harm motto. And for us in mining, we are driving safety performance through a number of strategies, and to be able to eliminate collisions means two things: operators are happy and therefore their mood is improved too. We are largely improving on the property damages cost. So for us, safety strategy in mining, this safe mine system has brought us very good fruits.
My name is Stephen Naritile. I'm the mining manager at Tinkal Services for Juanim Mine. And part of my job entails all the systems that have been introduced in the mine. So I generally look around the available technologies in the market and then assess their suitability for our operations. And if I believe they're suitable, then we procure such technologies to introduce into the mine. One of the introduced systems that we have introduced in Juanim is called a collision avoidance system, which helps us to reduce metal-to-metal contact on the equipment that we use at the mine. So essentially, the system allows the trucks to see each other, sense each other when they come to closer to a certain distance, and it does more in terms of assisting the operator to avoid contact with other equipment. The system also allows us to identify where dangerous areas are, in the sense that it allows us to geo-reference certain points in the pit where we believe that they pose a certain amount of danger, such that when the operators are in that area, they can at least be aware that they've got to be careful. I think we have introduced a lot more systems in the past, but this one really, it works, definitely works. We have seen a lot of reduction in our incidents, high potential incidents, where trucks are involved against each other when we compare 2016 versus 2015. So we have really seen a significant decrease in the number of incidents that we have had. My role to ensure the functionality of the system is to ensure that all the resources that are required to maintain the system are in place. All the necessary equipment that we procure on the mine that comes new, I've got to make sure that they get systems installed onto them before they can be employed in the mine. All the contractors that we bring into the mine, we check if their equipment have been installed with the system before they can be operated on the mine. I will say yes, it has improved our operations in twofold. Safety-wise, we have seen a serious decline in the number of incidents that we have had compared to the past years. And then secondly, we have seen a significant drop in the cost that we have incurred in damages related to equipment. So that means we have damaged less equipment this year, and we have spent less money in repairing equipment. And then thirdly, we have avoided any incident that could have resulted in people being hurt while at work. So I think it has done very well. And then obviously, we have seen the market improvement as well in our productivity. The way we use our equipment is much more productive now because operators are now less worried. They manage to maneuver faster because they're aware of the issues, other equipment around them. And by so doing, they're able to improve the productivity of equipment as well.